Hello, I'm Christopher Kennedy and welcome to The Short Lens. Short lenses are not always physically very small and you can of course have short zooms. In this case it goes from 10 to 22 millimeters. But whatever short lens you're using, you'll get a similar effect. If you look at this shot here, we're zoomed in with a very long lens, and then if we cut to the short lens, you can see that we get a very wide angle of view. We see lots of space and lots of distance. We'll look at that in terms of field of view, or angle of view as it's known. And you can see here that I'm about a foot away from the actor and the lens is zoomed out to nearly a medium lens. We'd still call this a short lens, but it's almost a medium lens. The background is a little bit blurred, and with short lenses you'll often find you can get absolutely everything in focus. So this is teetering towards being medium, but it's still quite short. But the important thing to notice is that you can just see the edge of the map on the wall up there, and you can see some of the computer. Then when we zoom out, we're on a slightly shorter lens now, and of course the actor seems to have moved further away from the camera, but also we have a wider angle of view. We can see wall on one side of the map now, and we can see almost all of that computer screen. So it's really important to know that without moving physically, we've increased the angle of view. Then if we zoom out again, getting even shorter, the angle of view becomes quite extreme. We can now see part of the bookshelf on the left, there's a lot of wall on the right, the actor's moved even further away from us. And then we'll zoom out to the very shortest lens on this camera, and we get a much wider angle of view. Even though we're very close, we're seeing quite a bit of the room. So of course, this can be used for shots like this, where you're trying to show a wide landscape. It can also be used when you're in a very tight space and you're trying to make the room look bigger or see more of the room. I'm going to set this to the shortest lens possible and then move closer to the actor. Here I'm about 4 feet away, and because the lens is very short, she looks quite a long way away. We've got a wide angle of view, we can see all the instruments against the wall and quite a lot of the wall. This is just 4 feet away. I've now moved into about 2 feet away. We look to be much further away than that because this is such a short lens. And we've still got quite a wide angle of view. We can see some of those instruments in the background. And now I'm just 1 foot away from the actress. So even though we're very close to her, she appears to be quite a distance away. And you can see the guitars in the background are starting to blur a little now. Now I'll repeat this with a longer lens. This is getting towards a medium lens, not quite medium, still a short lens, but you can see that starting from 4 feet away, it feels like we're 4 feet away. But the important thing to notice is that we have a much narrower angle of view. I can't really see much of those guitars, and there's also this effect of foreshortening. That wall seems closer to us than it did before. When I move to 2 feet away with this lens, it feels like we're getting much closer, and again, the angle of view is really narrowed down. I can only see two of the guitars, and that wall feels much, much closer. And from 1 foot away, this actually feels like we're using a long lens from across the room, and the wall feels much closer to us than it did before. It's really interesting to compare these two shots because the actor looks just about the same size in the frame, but everything else looks different. The image on the top left was shot with a very short lens, but from the middle distance, whereas the shot on the bottom right was shot with the longer lens, but from the furthest distance. And although the actor is the same size in the frame, her relationship to the background is incredibly different. On the top left, we can see all the angles of the floorboards, we see more of the room, she feels as though she's in the middle of the room, and on the right, everything else seems closer to her, the angles are all flattened out. So you can see on the top left that short lens has really had a very, very different effect to a more medium lens on the bottom right. Now a really short lens extends distance. So a room like this, which isn't that large, looks huge, but that also has the effect of making motion seem faster. So she moves across this room. She's only taking a few steps, but she goes from being normal sized in the frame to tiny in just a few steps. Equally, an object that appears very close to camera and very far away from the actor is only a few steps away, and she can cross that distance in just a few moments. This is an effect that's used all the time in film and television. It's particularly effective in scenes like this where you have someone moving down a corridor because the walls on the side emphasize the effect. And for scenes where you want to really increase the sense of motion, where, for instance, somebody's running, this is one of the best ways to make a slow jog look like a fast run. And because the short lens exaggerates speed, it can be used for shots like this, where the car was driving at a fairly normal speed down this road, but using the short lens, we made it look as though it was speeding past really fast. And then it disappears off into the distance, even though it was only probably going about 60 kilometers an hour. Here the actor is only sitting maybe a foot or two away from these berries, but her motion towards them seems really rapid and she seems to lunge towards the camera because of the short lens. In that first version I had the focus on the berries all the way through, but you can pull focus through a shot like this. So here I'm focused on her to begin with, and then as she moves forward, focus on the berries. And generally, when you use a short lens, more things stay in focus. So even though she's slightly out of focus there, she's not as out of focus as she would be if we were using a long lens. Of course, this is all affected by light and aperture as well, but in general, short lenses are sharper all the way through the image. For handheld shots such as this, the short lens is a good way of hiding the handheld look. It doesn't look too wobbly. And it's also a good way of exaggerating speed. You'll notice that I pass very close to the wall on the left here, and that makes it seem to rush by. You can see it rush past there, and then I move over to the right so the next wall rushes past on the right. By exaggerating speed in that way, you can really make it feel as though you're passing quickly through an environment. The short lens also makes it very easy to follow somebody when they're improvising. I asked the actor here to just move around the kitchen and see if I could follow her. This would be almost impossible with a long lens or even a medium lens. I wouldn't have been able to stay close to her. I wouldn't have been able to follow her motions without it looking too wobbly. And I certainly wouldn't have been able to keep it in focus. So we'll look at this shot from my feature film, The Sculptor's Ritual, which shows all these effects of the short lens. It's interesting to note that when we shot this, the camera operator was very close to that rock. You can see him dressed in black in the center there. He's just a few centimeters away from the rock. And when you see that on screen, the rock appears quite close, but certainly not centimeters away. And the actors are only about 10 feet away, but they look very small in the frame. So they have to take very slow steps at the beginning of this shot to prevent them looming up into the frame. So as we move across, they move up slowly, and because of the wide angle of view, we get to see the whole of this quarry. So we see the actors in the context of their environment. The camera is quite close to the actors there, but this is a good way of getting medium shots of the two of them and seeing the background. But as it moves around to the side, one actor is much closer to the camera, and that makes him appear much larger in the frame. And the two of them, even though they're walking shoulder to shoulder with just centimeters between them, appear to be quite distant. That's okay, so long as you're aware that it will have that effect. Now when they see someone in the distance, the camera swings around them, and that person who's not that far away appears to be a long, long way away just because the short lens pushes him so far into the background. It's worth taking another look at this end part of the shot where the actors swap sides, the actor on the right moves to the left, and the camera swings around them to bring the distant actor into view. But because the short lens keeps almost everything in focus, the actor in the background is in focus too. So we can see the foreground actors and the man in the background all at once. So I hope you have fun experimenting with the short lens, and that's the best advice I can give, is put one on your camera, get out there and start shooting.